Good morning, good afternoon, and great evening to my beautiful Walker Foundation family. How are y'all doing today? It feels so good to be back before you all. Listen, God bless y'all, but today we stand on my Father's business. Let's jump into it.
But you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Okay, y'all, so boom. Last night, right? I was just so happened to be in my prayer closet. And, you know, as I was praying to God, I was just like, you know, God, how can I, you know, still be able to be a kingdom financer and still be able to serve you and just, you know, mix those things in together, right? And then I look over at my Bible and my Bible is opened up to Psalms 112. Now, I'm gonna read this and y'all tell me what y'all think. So we're gonna start with Psalms chapter 112, verse 1. Let's jump into it. And I praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in his commandments. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Boom. So right there, it says that my seed, which is my children, my generation of like people that come from me, will be blessed. And I'm going to read that again. Praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in his commandments. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth, and the generation of the upright shall be blessed. Right? Good morning. Good morning, baby. All right, I am back. I had to plop some bacon in the oven, make me another cup of coffee, check on the baby, let the dogs out, pick up, scoop some poop, and I am back. How y'all doing? Okay, so first of all, this is Mr. Riches, and he is a father of 9 puppies, and he sleeps like he is a father of 9 puppies. All right, and he acts like he a daddy. But anyway, okay, guys, so I was talking about Psalms 112, right? But however, for those of you who are brand new here, welcome to the Walker Foundation family across the globe. Listen, this is a channel where we stand on our Father's business, right? I am a wife, a mom to 4 beautiful girls, and also a mom to 2 chihuahuas. So I am a dog mom, guys, and I am also on my way to being a multi-millionaire. Yay! So excited about that. And so we're going to get back into our Father's business. Okay, so Psalms 112, chapter 1. I'm going to just reread that because it's some good stuff. Okay, praise ye the Lord. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delighteth greatly in his commandments. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth. Hitting that, I'm going to read that again. His seed shall be mighty upon the earth. I tell my, that's so amazing because I tell my daughters every single morning before they go out to school. Well, one of them, Divine, you good? Well, one of them, I tell her every single day before she goes to school. And I also tell this to my 2 younger daughters too. But before Bella gets out of the car to go to school, guess what? I say, Bella, you are the lender, not the borrower. You shall be the one of the you shall be the greatest woman to walk the earth. You shall be the greatest woman to walk the earth. So it says in here, his seed shall be mighty upon the earth. The generation of the upright shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house. Wow, riches? Is that why you want to be a part of the video? You knew what was in Psalms. Okay, so wealth and riches shall be in his house. Wealth, listen, Psalms chapter 112, verse 3 says, wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness endureth forever. Unto the upright there ariseth light in the darkness. He is gracious and full of compassion and righteous. God, may we be gracious, full of compassion and righteous. A good man showeth favor and lendeth. He will guide his affairs with discretion. Surely he shall not be moved forever. The righteous shall be in everlasting remembrance. Wow. He shall not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established. His heart not, he shall not be afraid until he see his desire upon his enemies. He hath dispersed. He hath given to the poor. His righteousness endureth forever. His horn shall be exalted with honor, and the wicked shall see it and be grieved. He shall gnash with his teeth and melt away. The desire of the wicked shall perish. Wow. So it's saying basically that your enemies shall be so upset that you will, they gonna grant their teeth and be grieved, and they gonna just melt away. So that right there, you can say this, you know, if you have enemies or whatnot, it's okay. Bless them. Because guess what? God is going to prepare a table before your enemies, right? And it's not just talking about people that's out here walking. It's also talking about the enemy. Because the enemy is the enemy, the one that's in the enemy that's at your job. Or the enemy is the one who's in the enemy, you know, that's behind whoever you know, going back and forth with, or whoever it is that is hating on you or whatnot. It's the enemy. You know what I'm saying? So when you think about it, pray for those people. Pray for those people that persecute you. You know, I grew up in a household where, well, kingdom riches. Okay, y'all, so these are my two puppy wuppies. This is kingdom. This is riches. Kingdom riches. Kingdom riches shall flow unto me. Kingdom riches. And this is riches, and this is Rich's son right here. Right? So he's got 9 puppies. We kept one. Well, we kept 2 because my mom got one. But this is Kingdom Riches. And Kingdom is Rich's son. This is the daddy right here. But all right, you guys. So bless your enemies, y'all. We got to learn to bless our enemies, okay? So don't forget that. Now, guys, I'm going to put you down because I need to get to my other books, okay? Love y'all. All right. So, guys, let's go ahead and shut this beautiful word. I mean, you know, I'm so excited to just be able to have Psalms 112 to let me know that it's okay for me to be able to serve the Lord and still become a multimillionaire. Like, you know, because at first, you know, a lot of people think that serving the Lord, you have to be poor. No, God wants you to have wealth. He wants you to be able to help the mom that's struggling to feed her kids that's on the side of the road. You know, he wants you to be able to help people and help the poor, you know. So with that being said, Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this word. We receive this word. I receive every word that's in this book, Father God. Father God, allow your glory to be shown through my story. Amen. I receive that. All right. So let's get into this prayer, y'all. This is by Cindy Trim, guys. I tend to write down her prayers because they are so power-packed. Okay, so here's a warfare prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we repent for our sins right now, Lord God. I ask that you hearken unto this prayer for me and my family that's on this video. Okay. Holy Spirit, we invite you in. Listen, if you have not invited the Holy Spirit in, go ahead and invite the Holy Spirit in, right? We invite the Holy Spirit in. We invite the Holy Spirit in. Father God, in the name of Jesus, the author and finisher of my faith, I arise to establish my legal right and dominion over this region and over every territory you have given me jurisdiction over and authority. According to Daniel 9:4, you are the only great and dreadful God, keeping the covenant and mercy to them that love you and to them that keep your commandments. I appeal to the God who said in 2 Chronicles 7:13-16, if I shut up heaven that there be no rain, if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people which are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then Then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin. I will heal their land. And now mine eyes shall be open, and my ears shall attend to their prayer that is made unto this place. Now I have chosen and sanctified this house, so that my name may be there forever, and my eyes and my heart shall be perpetually there. I decree and I declare that this place is sanctified. I present my body as a living sacrifice by the shed blood of Jesus Christ, my Savior and my Redeemer. Make these prayers holy and acceptable unto you. I confess my sin and the sins of my forefathers. Let grace and mercy prevail over us. I decree and I declare that I have free passage for my prayers to ascend into the supernatural and will not be earthbound. I come into the agreement with the supreme good of heaven. I am seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. Therefore, I war from this plane and realm. I decree and I declare that the anointing of God break every yoke, open every portal, and assign angels to reinforce me as I advance into new levels, new dimensions, new realms and territories. Let there be a breakthrough in the heavens. I tap into apostolic and prophetic things. I shatter glass ceilings. I smash spiritual bars and iron membranes. I decree and I declare a breakthrough atmosphere is established. I recalibrate the spiritual climate, and I decree and I declare that every bit of lukewarmness must be replaced with the fire and the zeal of God. Baptize me with the Holy Ghost and fire. Let fire be in my mouth as I advance into this prayer. I take authority over demonic satanic atmospheres and climates created by occultic activities, destiny altered images, incantations, ill-spoken words, witchcraft, hostile environments, spoken words, hostile environments, fear, terrorism, racial, ethnic hatred, and violence. In the name of Jesus, I command that the spiritual climate shifts, economical climate shifts, social climate shifts, cultural climate shifts, educational climate shifts, political climate shifts, ecclesiastical climate shifts. I command that the atmosphere be filled with the glory of God. Father, fill the atmosphere in the environment with your glory. I now alter this environment. I decree and I declare that this environment is now suitable for my children to thrive, for my ministry to thrive, for my business to thrive, for my animals to thrive, for my babies to thrive, for my husband to thrive. This environment right here is suitable for me and my family to thrive. In the mighty name of Jesus, I establish a supernatural environment for miracles to occur. I war in the mighty name of Jesus by his shed blood, which is the shed blood of the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world. By him, evil must be destroyed. For this reason, the Son of God was made manifest, that he would destroy the works of darkness. I decree and I declare that the works of darkness be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. I decree that every curse over my life is reversed. I break through a prevailing. It's coming, baby. It's almost done, okay? It's almost done. Through your word, empower the angelic host to war on my behalf. I resist territorial strongholds. I sever ego entanglements. Open up the gates of psychological prisons and deliver us from the spirit of shame, embarrassment, harassment, iniquity. Deliver us from the spirit of strongholds and pride. Deliver me from... Okay, baby. Free me and my husband and my children and my family from limitations. I refuse to be marginalized, stigmatized, immobilized, terrorized, characterized, criticized, and tolerated, censored, misjudged, mishandled, mismanaged. I wear a cloak of favor. I disengage demonic triggers. I am non-responsive to demonic depression. I establish my superior authority over this region by the blood, by the word, and by the spirit of God. For this reason, I remind you that the Son of God was made manifest, that he would destroy the works of the devil. I decree and I declare that it is destroyed over this region, destroyed over my family, destroyed over my business, destroyed over my husband, destroyed over my children, destroyed over my body, destroyed over my house, destroyed over my loved ones, destroyed over every single neighbor that the plans of the enemies. It destroyed over every single neighbor that walks in this apartment complex. It is destroyed over my business partners. It's destroyed over everybody who I come in contact with in the name of Jesus. The enemy's plans is now canceled, shut down, dismantled, disengaged in the name of Jesus. Broken into pieces. The enemy's plans is now broken into pieces. I now smash it into pieces. And I bind the enemy up in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. God, I receive that prayer, Lord. And I just want to say thank you, God. And I just thank you, God, for hearkening unto that prayer just now. Thank you, Lord. And I just thank you, Lord, for it helping somebody that's under the sound of my voice right now. No, baby, not yet. Amen. Had to go get the bacon out of the oven. I like y'all, so I'm back. Okay, come on, Kingdom. So we got Kingdom back. So now let's go into these affirmations. Let me get some coffee. You can't get no coffee. Okay, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for that prayer. Lord, I just thank you for giving me the strength to be able to put your word out with all these animals and kids. Supernatural decrees. Let's get into it. All right. Confess these over your life every single day. You will see these words come to pass and things will literally change for you in the natural. I pray that every reader will walk into these supernatural declarations. These are powerful decrees. The word decree means an official statement that something must happen. Job chapter 22 and chapter 22 verse 28 says, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. All right, y'all, so let's go ahead and jump into it. I'm going to jump into the first five. Okay. I decree and I declare that I now receive supernatural wealth over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receives supernatural wealth over his life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive supernatural wealth over their life. I decree and I declare that I now receive supernatural blessings over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receives supernatural blessings over his life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive supernatural blessings over their life. I decree and I declare that I now receive supernatural overflow over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receives supernatural overflow over his life. I decree and I declare that my children shall have supernatural overflow over their life. And I'm talking about overflow all the days of their life. I decree and I declare that me and my husband now receive supernatural increase over our life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive a supernatural increase over their life. I decree and I declare that I now receive a supernatural success over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receive a supernatural success over his life. I decree and I declare that I receive supernatural victory over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receive supernatural victory over his life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive victory after victory after victory over their lives. I decree and I declare that I now receive supernatural power over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receive supernatural power over his life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive a supernatural power shot down from the heavens every single second of their life that they walk the earth. In the name of Jesus, I decree and I declare that I now receive supernatural vision over my life. I decree and I declare that my husband now receives supernatural vision over his life. I decree and I declare that my children now receive the vision from the heavens in the name of Jesus. And I mean that thing. Amen. Amen. All right. Okay, so we're going to confess these over our life every single day. You will see these words come to pass, and these things will literally change for you in the natural. I pray that everyone under the sound of my voice will walk into these supernatural declarations. These are powerful decrees. The word decree means an official statement that something must happen. Okay, so 1 John chapter 5, verses 14. And this is the confidence that we have toward him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Yay! Well, God, I mean, you know, just get excited because guess what? God heard your prayer today. And listen, if you have to, go back and repeat these things that I just read to you. Repeat these decrees over you and your husband. And if you don't have a husband, repeat them over him anyway. Because guess what? If you want a husband, he is coming. He will come. He's coming. He's on the way. So you need to go ahead and set these prayers in stone for him now. If you don't have children, go ahead and start speaking into their lives anyway. Because if you want children, they are coming. Your children are coming for you. You know? So God bless y'all. I hope y'all had a wonderful day because a wonderful time with me this morning because I sure did. I missed coming on here and I will be coming on here a lot more. Well, God bless y'all. I hope y'all have a wonderful, amazing day. And I'll talk to you soon, my friends. Bye-bye.
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should've known it.